I invite you now to pause and personalize the story, an important aspect of engaging the scriptures fully. What are your feeling responses to the story of Jesus' birth? Start with the story itself, and then expand the conversation to associated experiences of the times the story was told to you or by you, or times when the story was celebrated, prayed over, or overheard, or ignored, or rejected. Stay with the overriding feelings without judgment or intellectual critique. Next, recall the story surrounding your own births. Who was there? Who was absent? What was going on in your family at the time? What was going on in the world? Was it the best of times or the worst of times? If you do not know your own birth story, contact a friend or relative who may have some information. If that is not possible, imagine right now what you think it would have been like. Was your father able to be present with your mother? Or did work or military service, travel or war, divorce or separation make that impossible? Was the context of your birth the best or worst of times? Did you enter the world amidst joyful expectation or worries and anxieties? Was your wider family in harmony, or was it experiencing discord and strife, mother-in-law not speaking to daughter-in-law, or ruptures in relationships between fathers and sons, siblings, aunts, or uncles? Was your mother's life in danger when bringing you into the world? Was yours? Was your mother's life lost? Or were you born in a context of desperation of another kind? Perhaps you were put up for adoption. If so, can you see yourself for the first time in your adopted parents' home? For all this, thinking about your birth and yourself today, do you feel you were welcomed into the world, or do you continue to experience residue hurts or feelings of alienation? As you picture your arrival into the world, what are your dominant feelings or sentiments? If you are open to prayer, pray with these feelings, placing yourself and your feelings before God as you understand God. If not, if you are not comfortable, articulate your feelings and honor them as you meditate on the uniqueness of you, the particularities of your family, and then add to these the uniqueness of your religious or secular background, acknowledging the for better and for worse aspects of your story, for these will inform your self-understanding and affirm your solidarity with all of humanity. Now I invite the Christians to merge their stories and feelings with Jesus' story and the feelings that his story evoked. For people of other faiths, choose an analogous story of a birth from your own scriptures or tradition, be it the birth of Ishmael or Isaac, Joseph, Samuel, or Mohammed or Buddha, or the incarnations of Vishnu, and merge your thoughts and feelings about your birth with that story. And only if you wish, add those to what you may have experienced in relation to hearing Luke's gospel story of Jesus' birth. I invite secularists to merge thoughts and feelings concerning their birth with any significant birth story from their experience or from literature, and then, too, if you wish, with the Christmas story as you are hearing it now. Pause the CD now and address these thoughts and feelings. Don't forget to consult the feelings chart on the website as needed.